How's it going, everybody? My name is Yankee and welcome back to another video today. Now in today's video, guys, I am very excited to be showcasing to you a world record gameplay here in the Call of Duty Infinite Warfare beta. The gameplay you guys are going to be watching today is going to be the world's first atomizer strike here on the brand new multiplayer map Precinct, which was just added into the beta today. Now guys, I have to give credit where credit is due. This gameplay is by one of my really good friends, Shock Viper. Guys, I'm going to leave his link to his Twitch and his Twitter down in the description down below. Be sure to tell him that I sent you guys. He honestly is one of the best Call of Duty players I personally know, guys. He's always dropping ridiculous gameplays. He got one of the world's first nuclears in Black Ops 3 as well. I got to upload that personally. It was a lot of fun, so hopefully you guys will enjoy today's video, guys. And guys, oh my goodness, I'm freaking out. So the reason this is going to be the world's first, I don't know if anybody has uploaded a gameplay of this map yet, but this, as soon as this map dropped, he's telling me like 30 minutes after this map dropped is when he dropped this, and nobody else dropped one yet. Unfortunately, I was not able to upload this earlier because I was at work until 10 o'clock tonight. That's why this video is going to be coming out so late, so I do have to apologize to you guys about that. But again, I mean, this is just insane. This is the brand new multiplayer map. I haven't even played this thing yet. I literally just got home from work and I'm recording this commentary. But anyway, the weapon he is going to be using in this video is going to be the FHR-40, and he does have the legendary attach, or the legendary modification to the gun, which actually lets you go for that atomizer strike. So guys, the biggest question is, this kill streak a game ending streak? Everybody wants to know about that, and actually it will be a game ending kill streak, but only in TDM, unfortunately. That is the biggest blow right there. Unfortunately, it's only going to end the game if you are in TDM, and usually when you get the atomizer strike in TDM, the game is about to end anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But anyway, that is pretty cool. Either way, it's still going to work as a MOAB or a DNA bomb like we've seen in the past in every other game mode, which is still something that is very awesome. I'm really excited that something like this is coming back, and it's actually going to be a lot more common than people thought that are going to be able to drop these kind of gameplays as well, which I'm looking forward to that. I cannot wait until I unlock one of these weapons that have that legendary attachment to it. And the way that he actually got this weapon, he didn't actually get it out of a supply drop. He didn't spend any salvage on it. He just got to level 22. And we, like the same thing I talked to you guys about earlier today, through the mission team depot, all you have to do is just unlock, like, do some challenges, keep leveling up in the game, and you're going to start unlocking some weapons, which is something that I found really cool. They're really going to start rewarding players that sit down and play the game for a long period of time, which is something a lot of people have been asking for a long, long time. But oh, one thing I do have to point out, that it's actually going to be very difficult to actually get these kind of gameplays. Like I said many other times, you have to get all 25 kills with the weapon of the, like, the legendary attachment. If you get any kills with the grenade, if you get any kills with the specialist, or any kills with the secondary, those kills will not count towards your nuke streak or your atomizer streaks, unfortunately, which is something I'm a little disappointed about, but it does make sense. So in this beta, there is no scavenger. That is the biggest challenge right now, is that there's no scavenger. So if you're running out of ammo and you have that nuke and you're like three off, and all of a sudden you run out of ammo, no matter how many more kills you get, you're not going to get that atomizer strike. So one of the biggest things that happened in this game was the fact that he actually does switch sides after the domination. So there was an intermission. He got to get all the ammo back in his gun again, which is something that was absolutely huge. Now there is one thing that I do have to talk about that I'm not a big fan about with this atomizer strike. For some reason, it's like every time you get a kill, or maybe every other kill, something like that, a little thing pops up saying how many kills away you are from that atomizer strike. I personally am not a big fan of this, because it's just going to add so much extra pressure to you when you're going for these gameplays. Like, when I'm sitting down and I'm going for a streak, I never look at my scoreboard, because I'm like, all right, I do not want to know how many kills off I am. I'm just going to play the way I play, and I'm going to just hopefully drop this nuclear as soon as possible. Now, the fact that it's right there in your face every time you get a kill saying you're three kills off, you're two kills off, that's just going to keep adding more pressure to you to keep getting those kills. And I feel like people might be choking more gameplays when they're going for them, because this thing keeps popping up in their face. So I'm not sure if I really like how that looks, but again, that is just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think about that in the comments down below, guys. Also, one other thing is, since it is like a MOAB and a DNA bomb, it actually does like create a little haze on the screen, like we've seen back in COD Ghost and Modern Warfare 3. Every other game like that, we have seen like a little haze around the map after they do drop this atomizer strike. Some people like it, some people don't. Personally, for me, I really just do not care, but it's definitely, I'm just excited the fact that the nuke is back, the fact that we're seeing another kill streak like this. But unfortunately, we didn't see anything like that in Black Ops 3. I'm excited to see this back here in Infinite Warfare as well. So anyway, guys, thank you all so much for watching this video. And if you guys did enjoy it, as always, be sure to drop a like, guys. Let's go for about 20 to 30 likes, guys. This is a world record gameplay, so all the support on this video really would mean a lot. Of course, go over, check out Shock Viper, the one that actually got this gameplay, guys. Be sure to tell him that I sent you. His links will be down in the description down below. I'll catch you all next time. Once again, thank you all so much for watching, and have a good day, guys. Peace out.